The plot revolves around, I really follow the story of cancer as it's moving around the world, actually. It's not only United States, but, you know, there, in this story, like in many stories, there's some nodes. The Dana-Farber is one such node because, again, the pace of discoveries, starting with Sidney Farber, is accelerated around here. And then you go to, you know, you move from Boston to Bethesda, where, again, carrying forward Sidney Farber's work, Emil and Emil, Fry and Freireich, really managed to combine chemotherapies and begin to start curing acute lymphoblastic leukemia, which is a real milestone in this whole story. So I really follow the story, and part of the challenge of writing the book, but also coming back to the question of the Dana-Farber, is that there is a story to be told. It's, you know, there is a conversation that occurs across several decades, which begins in about, you know, 1940 and ends, it really doesn't still end, but continues over time. And so that conversation moves from one place to another place, and characters come in and go out, but it's a conversation. Well, Sidney Farber is particularly important in the story, not only because of his scientific contributions, but really because of his political and public contributions. And in particular, Sidney Farber is, of course, remembered in the history of science as one of the inventors of chemotherapy, the idea of a chemical being able to go into your body and kill cancer cells specifically and spare other cells as much as possible. So he's one of the fathers of chemotherapy. But then Sidney Farber had another very crucial insight, which is very important to the story, which is that Farber began to wonder whether to bring cancer alive in the public imagination, whether one needed to do more than just being a scientist. And it's this capacity of Farber, the capacity of Farber to come outside the laboratory and to become engaged in a much larger public conversation around cancer that occurs in America in the 1960s, that was to me very important because it represents actually also the emergence of cancer itself from a very private space, a disease that no one talked about, into the public imagination. So Farber's transformation, you know, he first used Jimmy and the Jimmy Fund as a kind of icon to personalize cancer in the public imagination, and then reached beyond Jimmy in collaboration with Mary Lasker to really create a national platform for cancer. And that was, for me, very important, this transformation from a scientist to a public intellectual.